Thank you. Thanks a lot. I welcome you all for our tuning in session with Dr. Nilima on natural skincare. Before we begin, I would like to introduce our session for today and talk a little bit about our sacred space. Our sacred space is a center for folk and classical art, environmental work, sustainable agriculture, sustainable architecture, health, wellness, and inner work. It was founded by Nayanatara Nandakumar in 2012 in the heart of Sikandrabad. The place is built by using natural materials. The center offers classes, workshops in art, dance, music, yoga, theater, and events and performances were also held. We were one of the first ones in the city to host an organic market called Adivaram Angadi on every Sunday since 2014. Chaura, our auditorium, was inaugurated in 2016 with a 500 seating capacity. We've hosted several handloom exhibitions, plays, dance and music festivals, limb donation and blood donation camp. The Telangana Heritage Center of Our Sacred Space in Darud, Vikarabad district, was launched in 2017. The Heritage Center is created to help preserve local agricultural, architectural, artisanal practices. Since its inauguration, we had a number of programs and workshops for the local community. We've organized health camps, summer camps, music and dance performances, film screenings, workshops, homestays, and retreats for rural and urban, as well as international participants at Our Sacred Space, Telangana Heritage Center, Darur. I would like to now invite Nayanatara Nandakumar ma'am to introduce the speaker.
Welcome, Nilima. Lovely to see you.
Hi. Thank you, Taraji.
I will ask my mother to introduce Tuning In, the series that we started since we've gone online with the pandemic.
Okay.
Tuning In. The intent of this lecture series is to analyze paradigms of development and explore findings on environment, sustainability, and social justice. The present pandemic has brought an awareness that all life is one. Deeply connected are all organisms. We have come to realize that it is imperative that we live in consonance with nature. No longer can we afford to flout our duty towards Earth. As we understand that our destinies are interdependent, our ways of doing business, politics, agriculture, our consumer habits and social transactions have changed. This crisis has catalyzed that change. Our rampant consumerism and rapacity to explore the Earth's resources have shifted into a relationship of reverence for nature, reverence for life, and an awareness that all life is one. They say that where your passion is intersects with what society needs is where your life's work lies. Nilima is one of those really fortunate people in that she's following her passion and she's doing something really significant for society.
Thank you so much, Auntie.
Dr. Nilima Konuru is the founder of N Mantra, a natural organic skin and hair wellness company. Her mission is to innovate products that are free of petroleum, paraben, and toxic chemicals for all ages with unique formulations. She holds a PhD in biochemistry from University of Hyderabad and is a postdoctoral fellow at University of Toledo. She completed her basic bioinformatics study from Stanford University
and is a visiting scholar at University of Pittsburgh with research experience in anti-aging, anti-cancer, and drug designing. Now, how fortunate are we that the hair and skin care that we use is made by someone so qualified, so knowledgeable. And every day that I use Enmantra's products, I'm so grateful that our family has an option to use products that are actually healthy for us. Welcome, Neelima. Welcome to Tuning In.
Thank you, Taraji. And I'm really grateful to our Secret Space and Taraji and Nalini Aunty for always encouraging me and always promoting Enmantra's products. Thank you so much. So let's start with a small presentation I've made to explain why natural skincare. If anyone has any questions, please stop me and you can ask any time during the presentation, or else we can discuss at the end. Yeah, thank you. Just give me a minute, please. So yeah, these are some of the points which we are going to discuss today, like a little about how the human skin is structured and how we can understand what our skin type is, then what are the factors which affect the skin type, and both internal and external, and why is it important to know about our skincare products, because I will explain why I call it unhealthy skin products, and about all the product recalls which happen, which would surprise us a lot, and how to avoid all these chemicals which are there in the skincare products. And then finally coming to why we would choose a natural skincare product, or why is it important to go for a natural product. So here is a basic structure of the human skin. You can see different layers of the skin, and what we would primarily focus on is, So what we would primarily focus on is the sebaceous gland here. That would actually give out sebum, and that the amount of sebum present in on our skin actually categorizes our skin into dry skin or oily skin or normal skin, depending on the amount of sebum which is produced by these sebaceous glands. And you can actually see that whatever we put on our skin goes as deep as the arteries and veins, and in the products actually get into our bloodstream. And as I mentioned, depending on the amount of sebum, either our skin is dry, normal, oily, or combination skin. And a normal skin is a well-balanced skin where the sebum levels are pretty much normal, neither it's too oily or too dry. And the dry skin is because of the, lack of moisture which is retained in the lipids of the skin layer. And the lipids are the basic, protective shield on our skin, and it protects us from all the environmental factors or, all the pollutants which we, face throughout the day when we, or environmental factors and all the other things. And oily skin is a kind of skin where the sebum levels are really high. And combination skin, as we all know, the T-zone on our face actually shows up as oily and the rest of the cheeks and other areas are dry. So that's a combination skin. So each one is dealt with in a different way with the products, but the kind of products which we use. And yeah, that is about the skin types. So these are the kind of factors which affect the skin. So basic genetics of a person, then the hormones. If the hormones are not balanced, it shows up on our skin, like very dry or very oily or acne prone skin because of the hormones. And age, of course, due to the age, moisture retention on the skin can either mostly decreases, and mostly aged people have dry skin because of that. And the diet and food, kind of food which we eat, also influences the skin. And medication, the kind of if we are on any specific medication, that can influence the type of skin which we have. Like it can either get very dry or very oily, or you know, it can vary. Coming to the external factors, we have the weather conditions, the kind of amount of sun exposure which we get, or depending on the area where you know there's too much radiation, we can get sunburns and things like that. And pollution is a major factor these days because of all the vehicular pollution and pollution from the industries and stuff like that. And allergies, due to allergies like allergies or allergic conditions like eczema, the skin can get very dry, and you know, it would need more nourishment. And lifestyle, lack of sleep and you know, too much stress and things like that. So these are some of the external factors which influence skin. So coming to the unhealthy skin products, so you'll be surprised at you know how many products are out there which are positive for you know lot of these carcinogenic chemicals. And that is why it is really important to you know read what's on your product. Sometimes they may be listed, sometimes they might not be, and you would be surprised at all these big companies which are trusted brands are you know contain all these carcinogenic chemicals. So these are some of the there's a list of products which have dioxin, which is a known carcinogen, or formaldehyde containing products. So I wouldn't take any specific names, but yeah, these are the two most important carcinogenic chemicals found in products. And talking about product recalls, so it's again surprising to know that lot of these known brands are recalled every year for the kind of ingredients which go into their products, or the kind of QA which is not happening properly, like the quality control, quality assurance. And you can see that Johnson & Johnson baby lotion was recalled for bacterial content in it. So that's a little shocking to know. And asbestos present in Johnson & Johnson powder, baby powder, which is the most trusted brand across the world. And yeah, a lot of these things happen. And coming to, you know, so number of recalls are increasing every year. Like, you know, there was 63% hike in 2016 for the number of products which are recalled. And you can see here that, you know, so most of them from different countries, a lot of these brands from different countries were recalled, and 22% from United States, 19% from India, and all the other countries, European countries, and all kinds of places. And here are the range of products which are recalled every year, like bath and body products to, you know, baby products to cosmetics, and all kinds of products are recalled every year. And to our surprise, we can see in the on the slide that, you know, baby products are the most recalled among the products which are recalled. And that is one big shocker which I got when I had my kid. And coming from a, you know, a scientific background, and I always had this habit of reading the ingredients before I buy any product. And it was just shocking to know that all these carcinogenic chemicals go into products. And I just couldn't help it but to, you know, start researching on these, coming from a science background. And I really wanted to make products which are free of all these chemicals. So you can see here that sunscreen has a list of chemicals, and you know, all the surfactant containing shampoos, conditioners have, you know, lots of chemicals. Propylene glycol, which is a commonly used ingredient in lotions and creams, that also has hazardous, you know, that found to be hazardous to the health, according to a lot of research articles. And fragrance, of course. Fragrance is one of the another factor, toxic, which is found toxic for the health. And these are some of the chemicals which are found in shampoos, like parabens. Parabens are, you know, hormonal disruptors. And due to this, there are lots of research articles on linking these parabens to breast cancer and other kinds of cancers. And there are so many other chemicals like silicones and triethanolamine and formaldehyde and triclosan, which is usually, triclosan is very commonly found in hand washes and, you know, shampoos and stuff. And mineral oil. Mineral oil is another toxic, you know, ingredient, because it actually blocks the pores on the skin. And due to which there's not enough secretion of sebum, and there's no way for the toxins to come out of the skin. And these blockages can even eventually cause cancers. So here is another list of chemicals which go into personal care products. A big list, actually, to our surprise. From toothpaste to baby products to shampoos, conditioners, air fresheners, and even balms which we apply for headaches. So all these contain these chemicals. So I would like to talk a little more about artificial fragrances and their effect on our body. And a lot of people, I'm sure, experience some of these symptoms with when they smell a strong perfume, or, you know, or a product which is very strong on fragrance. And this is a very common one, migraine headaches. Even I have that problem. And some people even get asthma attacks with it. And some get to an extent, go to an extent where they get these neurological problems like seizures and dizziness and things like that. Headache is a very common one, but seizures also. And some experience allergies with artificial fragrances, and some get nauseic, and you know, they get a bloating and nausea and vomiting sensation with the artificial fragrance. And some get nasal congestions, or it can even go to cognitive or, you know, symptoms, or even cardiovascular symptoms in rare cases. So coming to our key topic today, natural products. I just wanted to I explained all those points about toxic chemicals because it is important for us to know what's in our product, and we need to know what exactly goes into our products. So once we know that all these are there, it is it gets to a point where we have to switch to a product which don't contain all those toxins. And that is why we have to come choose a natural product which are free of these toxic chemicals or artificial fragrance or aluminium, which is another toxin, or parabens or petroleum or mineral oils, no petroleum products. And so why we choose natural and organic products is they have very nourishing ingredients like shea butter, cocoa butter, and natural oils like almond, argan, macadamia nut, olive oil, and stuff like that. And then plant-based ingredients like aloe vera, vegetable glycerin, and natural plant-based emulsifiers, thickeners, and infused liquids like rose water and stuff. And essential oils are primarily used in natural products to fragrance the product or enhance the product efficacy, like we use in the N-Mantra products. Like we primarily use lavender, lemongrass, rose, sandalwood, jasmine. These are some of the examples of the essential oils which go into natural products. And there's many advantages using essential oils. Like their first one is they're completely natural and plant-based. And these aromatherapy oils, which we call them as, essential oils are also called aromatherapy oils. And these are mainly used for massages and stuff for enhancing the mood or energizing a person. Apart from these things, we should also know that these are antibacterial, antiviral, and antifungal. And they carry a lot of antioxidant properties. And there's a lot of research going on their anti-cancer activity also, which, attracted me the most because I come from a anti-cancer research background. So it was interesting for me to know that when I started researching on these essential oils and essential oil-based products. So our journey basically started in the US. And we started out N-Mantra in 2011. That was because my son had eczema and sensitive skin. And since I come from a research background, I was very skeptical about putting these commercial products with all these chemicals on him. So I started experimenting with my own creams in my garage in Bellevue. And so far I have not used any chemical-based products on my daughter, who was also born in 2011 in Bellevue. And my son's eczema is completely cured. And this actually inspired me and my husband to start N-Mantra. So yeah, we founded this company, and yeah, here we are in India. We moved back in 2015, and we have a manufacturing facility now in the industrial area in Balanagar, and we manufacture with all the regulations. We follow all the regulations for natural skincare product production. And so here is our website. You can check us out on nmantra.in. I hope I was not too fast. I can take any questions if anyone has any. Thank you so much, our Sacred Space, Taraji, and Nalini Aunty, for this opportunity.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Neelima. So this goes out to all the participants. In case you have any questions, please leave them in the chat box and we will pick the relevant ones, and Dr. Neelima will answer them to you.
I hope I didn't go too fast and no, I...
It was perfect.
Okay.
Excellent overview of, you know, so yeah. I have been reading about the issues of toxins in hair, cosmetics.
Yes.
But I did not realize the, you know, length and breadth and, you know, how important it is that you're putting on newborn babies.
Yes, exactly. That was one big shocker for me, because when I first went to US and when I checked out the ingredients on baby products, I realized most of them are very toxic, and I was just shocked to see them. And then I thought it's very important for us to develop something which is free of all these chemicals, because what we put on our skin is okay, but a baby's skin would absorb whatever is put on, and it's not good. So
so many times even so-called Ayurvedic products do contain paraben.
Yeah, the problem is with the regulatory agencies which don't regulate the base ingredients of these products. And you would be surprised at all those chemicals which are used for those Ayurvedic creams and shampoos and stuff. So, yeah, even though there are regulations, I don't know if how much of that people follow to manufacture their products. And they still call it organic or natural or I don't know.
Before we move on, I'd like to invite Nipunika to show a small presentation on our Sacred Space upcoming events.
Thank you, Shikhara. So these are our upcoming events, both online and offline at our Sacred Space. We have our next tuning in series on Leonine Tales, Stories of Asiatic Lions by Dr. Ravi Chellam next Saturday, that is 28th November, from 5 p.m. to 6:15 p.m. Tomorrow at our space in Secunderabad, we have an Adopt a Pet, Don't Shop puppy adoption drive, a pottery workshop from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. Then we have online painting workshops on 22nd November. And then we have our natural cure for diabetes tomorrow from 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. This is an online webinar. Another painting workshop on 29th November from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Then we have arranged a series of workshops just for the Christmas break, starting with brush calligraphy workshop. Then we have math tables online workshop from 25th December to 31st December. Handwriting for kids, again on the same dates. Hindi poetry workshop from 26th to 28th December. Theater workshop for kids from 26th to 29th December. And then we have our regular classes throughout the year, starting with yoga for senior citizens. Online yoga classes, 7:15 to 8:15 a.m. batch. Speed cubing classes for kids. Online shloka classes for both kids and adults every weekend. Online Urdu classes every weekend. Kalari Payattu classes on the weekend every evening. Kuchipudi classes by Ms. Amy Kumar. Odissi classes, all of which are happening online right now. Please contact us on this number for further details. Over to you, Shikhara. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Nipunika. Dr. Neelima, we'll move on to taking the questions.
Sure, yeah.
The first question here is what is the shelf life of your products?
So typically we have a shelf life of 1 year for our products. And we use very minimal quantities of preservatives and stabilizers, chemical stabilizers in our product. We don't use any, but for creams, we do use some emulsifiers and stuff, which some basic preservatives, which gives them a shelf life of around 1 year. Yeah.
All right. Thank you. There's a question from Niharika. Mm-hmm. She says, how to know that the product is damaging our skin and getting into our bloodstream?
So before you buy any kind of skincare product or food product or any product, it's important for us to know what's going into that product. And how do you know it's damaging? You would know the effect. If it's on the skin, you would know the effect in a couple of weeks or months or whatever. You will know if it's suiting you by touch and feel or any rashes or itchiness on your skin. Coming to getting into the bloodstream, that is a little difficult to find out, because eventually any product which you use on your skin would get into the bloodstream when the product is absorbed onto your skin. So it's difficult to actually track that till that level. But it's better to avoid all those products which have toxic chemicals in them. Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Could you please suggest a product to treat acne for all skin types?
All skin types. Okay. We do have an acne pack, acne gel. And those two have been very effective for acne. And that's like one is like a face pack, which you can use twice a week or up to thrice a week even. And there's one more product, which is a gel, which you can apply every night before you go to sleep. So these are based of aloe vera and tree tree oil and other ingredients, which are very effective for acne.
Moving on, which product is good for dark pigmentation on the face?
Okay. We do have a face pack for that again. And we also have a facial serum, which is for daily night application before going to bed. And that's been very effective and we have very good reviews for that product. Night facial oil, we call it. And that's a blend of 7 different oils, which are very effective for pigmentation, along with a blend of essential oils again.
All right. Is there any shampoo based on shikakai?
We have a hair wash powder actually, which is very, very effective. It's a little tedious to use that when compared to the normal shampoos. But then it's very effective when used along with the anti-hair fall hair oil, which we have. It's a Rita and shikakai based, along with 10 to 12 different herbs.
All right. Can you suggest something for under eye area?
Under eye, again, I would suggest the facial serum, which is safe to apply on the eye area also. So.
Okay. So there's one question that says how to buy your product. I'd like to answer that.
Yeah.
Sure. N-Mantra's products are available in our sacred space every Sunday. Now we are not open every Sunday, but every time we do a Angadi, you're all welcome to visit and then purchase. Either Dr. Neelima or her husband will be there showing you all the products. We ourselves have bought so many of them, so we can really vouch that they're really, really good.
Yeah, again... I think we're all waiting for the Our Secret Space store to open, and our products would be available there as well. Or they can always message me, or we can ship it to them also.
Definitely. That is the last question. Do you have online delivery? Yes,
we do.
Yeah.
You can order from our website, or we have our contact number on the website. You can message us and we do deliveries all the time. Yes.
All right. So that is it with the questions. Okay. I'd like to now invite Nayantara ma'am to take it further.
I hope whatever I explained was clear to everyone. And please do make it a point to read the ingredients of a product whenever you buy one, and know the ingredients in your product. Very important.
During the pandemic, I didn't have a supply of and Mantra shampoo, and I was using a substitute. And my hair was just falling in clumps, you know.
Oh.
And then you brought some bottles and gave me, and it's been, I can just feel the difference. It's as if my scalp is telling me, yes, I have.
Thank you, Nalini Aunty.
So the pandemic has really brought us, given us a wake-up call that, our lifestyle can, our choice of lifestyle can make a difference for us, for the future generations, for this planet. And Neelima's work is powerful beyond one person and one family. Her knowledge, her background of science, and her commitment to creating a product which is so comfortable to use, so luxurious to use really, and healthy for you, especially when, you know, the knowledge we have of the kind of toxins, which has really been augmented today with your presentation, Neelima. So much information, so specific. I think knowledge really in this these situations is power, because while we work hard, we give our family the best, healthiest food and environment. Sometimes these things like the skincare, the toothpaste, the shampoos that we use are, silently bringing toxins into our body and creating so much of ill health that, again, we, often treat with pharmaceuticals. So this is a wonderful way to respond to the pandemic, the crisis that has woken us up, as we can further refine our lifestyles, our lives. And thank you, Neelima. Look forward to having you at Angadi and when we open our store.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, there are things which we can avoid, and this is one of them. And because we can't, change the climate or weather conditions or environment pollution and all that is out of our hands. And food and products which we use are something which we can choose and we can change. So that's what we believe in Mantra, that, nature is always helpful and nature never goes out of style. That's our tagline for in Mantra. So thank you
to Secunderabad. We're grateful to you.
Thank you so much, Taraji. Thanks for all your support and encouragement.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Nalini. There's one last question from Padmini Raghavan. Is there anything bad in using shikakai alone?
No, there's nothing wrong, nothing bad about it. But only thing is, some people have this, concern that it doesn't clean the oil completely. Because what I have observed with, using shikakai is, it's very conditioning. So it doesn't, some people feel that it doesn't clean the hair completely. It doesn't clean the oil on the hair. So that's the only thing. Otherwise, it's a natural, ingredient, and it's really good if it's suiting you, if it's suiting your hair type. So
thank you so much for being very patient in answering all our questions. With this, we come to the end of this session. I thank everyone. I thank you, Dr. Neelima, as well as...
thank you, Shikara. Thank you, Nipunika. And thank you, everyone at our sacred space.
Hope to see you again soon.
Yes. Sure. Thank you.
We come to the end of this session. Thanks for all the participants who have joined. Please be in touch with us for our upcoming sessions as well.
Take care
and good night. Have a nice weekend, everyone.
You too. Thank you.